here with very interesting activities from the material we have at our home. Like today, this activity is going to be very amazing. You know how? Because I am going to use the old broken crayon, as you people also will be having at your home, right? So, and what else I am using? Candles. Breaking this, crushing into pieces, then I will be making a magical candle. Okay, so let's get ready. Let's begin for this step one. So your step one is to take crayons. You can take in any bowl, and you have to make more pieces out of it. Okay, then you need to make pieces of the wax. You can break the pieces. Okay. Okay, then after this, I'm going to mix this crayon and I will be making orange color candle. Okay, you can use any other color which you want, right? So this is the material which I'm going to use for the candle making. I will be pouring this crayon and wax into the pan. Now you can see I have a bowl in which crushed pieces of wax and the crayons are there. So you can use knife also, or you can break into smaller pieces. Okay, and see, like you can use the wax. You can take the help of knife as well. But in this you need help of your parents so that no harm should be caused to you. See, I hope you can see I am separating the wax from the candle wick. Now this material we are going to pour into the pan and we will melt it for 5 to 10 minutes. Now you can see I have crushed crayons and wax in the bowl. Now I am going to pour this into this pan. But before pouring it, let me tell you, I am using induction here and this pan. Make sure that your pan has a strong and sturdy base so that it will not create any problem, it will not cause any harm to you. So now our step is to pour this wax and crayons into this bowl. I hope you can see I have kept all the material in the pan. It's ready for melting. We have to melt this for around 5 to 10 minutes. Yellow crayons. Can you see? I wish to add these crayons. It can give any attraction part to it. Let's see what color we will be getting. For this, you can take help of your parents as well, because it's not that much safe for you people, right? And stir this. This is about to melt. It will hardly take 2 more minutes. Have you ever imagined wish to make candle of your own choice of your color, you can use any other color, and even you can mix some colors to it. It will be a colored candle, okay? Now this is almost melt. Now we will wait for around 1 minute. Let it cool down before we pour into the glass. Let's wait for 1 minute before to pour down it in the glass. Now you can see it's melt completely, and now you can it's ready for pouring this into the glass. So now see, I'm going to pour this. So I have two options here. One is this glass and second one is this bowl. So I wish to pour this in this bowl, as it will look more beautiful if we will be making candle in this bowl. So look here everyone, now I am pouring this. In this way you can pour all the material you have prepared, and now you can see our candle is halfway ready. I have poured this wax and crayon into this bowl, and now see, I have added a string to it. String means it's wick which we used to burn, right? So I have added this through this iron nail. You know why I have used this iron nail? I have tied a thread, a wick, to the iron nail so that it can be sit straight, right? So we don't need to hold this wick for a long time. We can only put this, we don't need to hung it for long, right? So now what we need to do, we need to wait for some time. Then we need a container with cold water. We need to put this bowl into that so that your wax can get hardened, and after that we need to wait for one hour around so that your wax can settle and get harder for complete candle. Okay, so let's bring a container filled with cold water. Now you can see I have a container, or you can take any vessel, put some water into it, and the water should be cold so that your wax can settle. Now I will be putting this bowl with the candle wax into it. For few minutes you need to do this so that your wax can get hardened. Now you can see I have kept my candle into this vessel filled with cold water. The vessel is half filled actually, and you need to keep the water, quantity of water should be according to the height of your candle, okay, so that no water can enter into this candle. And we need to leave these for around 5 minutes. Let's wait for 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes you can see your wax has will settle down, and then you need to leave this for around 1 hour. After an hour your candle will be ready, and then you can decorate it well. Now I am bringing this bowl out from the vessel, and I keep it here for around an hour. It's almost set, but we will keep this around for one more hour so that this wax can get hardened and set for the perfection, okay? And see, I have taken very less amount of water. You also need to take less quantity of water so that this water cannot enter into your bowl while making this hard, okay? And soon after keeping it in the water for 5 minutes, you need to keep it out for around an hour. And yes, we need to wait for an hour so that it can get set and get hardened. So after an hour you can see your candle will be perfectly ready for litting. Then we can do some decoration part also. If you have at your home, we can keep the flower petals around it and we can decorate in many other ways. I have an idea. Let me show you how I am going to decorate my candle. I would like to suggest you can decorate the candle beautifully by spreading the leaves of flowers around it. Hannah, it's looking nice. And then you can also, after spreading the leaves near it, you can also add some glitter to it. See, I am having a packet of glitter. I was having at my home. You can add here to give it an enhanced look. I feel it's looking more beautiful after adding this. As you can see, I'm adding glitter here, and for presenting this, can you see? I hope it's looking beautiful. I have presented this beautifully. Now I would like to show you one another way of decorating my candle. Okay, I hope you all are ready for another look for making it more beautiful. So I would like to add some thermocol balls here, which I was having at my home. See, it will look very beautiful after adding this. Can you see how I am spreading it around it? Okay, so these thermocol balls adding grace to our candle. I feel it's not looking like it's homemade, right everyone? I hope you also like it and appreciate the procedure of making the candle, and I hope you all will try at your home. You can make it more beautiful. You can also use colorful thermocol balls in spite of having these white ones, and you can make it more beautiful by adding one more layer to it. Like it's of orange color, you can add any light color layer. Like you can use yellow crayons and wax to make one more layer over it, and it will look more beautiful if you will make a it will look more beautiful if you will make different layers over it. And you can use other mold and utensils as well to make the desired shape. If you have any star shaped bowl at your home, or if you want to make any other shape, you can use other mold. Like I have used this circle shape, sphere. To light this beautiful candle, I hope it will look beautiful after lighting. See, it's looking beautiful, just like normal candles like we used to buy from the market. See everyone, you don't need to buy candles from the market. You can decorate at your home only, and see how beautiful it's looking. You only need to present it well. I hope you like it and you will also try making this at your home. This is the easy way to make a candle at your home by using only the materials. This is the another candle which I made using the glass. As you can see, I have shown in the video also. Here I have used the glass to make a beautiful decorative candle. I hope you will like this one also, and do try this at your home and share with us. Thank you. like making the making the candle with the procedure I have told you. You can also prepare such kind of candles with disposal also. If you don't want to use glass bowl, then you can use disposal also. Later on, you can cut the outer part and bring the candle out. When your material gets hardened inside this, the wax will get hardened after an hour. You can cut this and remove the disposal plastic from outside, and then you can get it, let it settle for an hour. Then you can use the candle in the same way I have used these candles. So I hope you liked it, and do try. Let's have a quick recap of the procedure of making the candles at your home. So firstly, what we did, we took wax and colorful crayons of your choice, then crush it well, mix it well, then take an induction or you can use the gas, melt it for around 5 to 10 minutes, then keep stirring that frequently, and after stirring, slim the gas, turn the gas off, then you can convert, you can pour the mixture of wax and crayon from the pan to the glass or bowl or any desired mold or shape which you want, and then you have to put this bowl or glass in the water for 5 minutes. After keeping that for 5 minutes in the water, you need to keep it still for around 1 hour to get your wax settled down and get hardened. After getting it hard, you can, but before getting it used or keeping for an hour, you make sure that you have kept the wick inside it, you have put the wick inside it, and then you can wait for an hour to use the candle. Later on, you can use the you can decorate it well and light the candle to use. That's it. Now I wish to wind off my session. Before winding it off, I would like to introduce Ms. Sheenu Khurana ma'am. Now she will be taking the following session, and she will teach you how to make beautiful creative pots at home. Hope you will like it also. So do attend that class and make beautiful crafty pots at your home. That's all. Bye bye everyone.
How are you all? I hope you all are going very fine. As I hope that Jasmine ma'am has introduced me before only, but still I would like to introduce myself once again. I am Sheenu, and today I am here with a very interesting activity for you all. Before starting with the activity, I want to ask one thing. Can you guess what we are going to make actually today? With the material that is available at our home. Okay, so I'm having one bottle, and with this bottle I am going to prepare a very beautiful pot, and I hope this pot will look very attractive, very beautiful and very cute after it will get prepared. And see, this will be the pot that we are supposed to buy from the market. And what if we can prepare it at our home only, if we are having the material? And the material is very quite simple, which is easily available with everyone. Okay, and I am very excited to prepare a cute pot for myself. So I am ready with the material, and I hope you all will also prepare it and you will feel very very good after preparing such a lovely pot. So let's start with the activity. Okay, so for preparing a crafty pot, we will be needing one bottle of 2 liters and one white paint color, painting brush, water, marker of black color, pencil, cutter for cutting the bottle so that we can give the shape of a pot. And here are some cuttings I was having already and through which we will be giving a cute shape to our pot by preparing the ears. Okay, so let's get started for the activity. With the help of the cutter, now we will cutting this bottom part of the bottle. Okay? So in this procedure you can take the help of your parents also, as it will be difficult for you to use as it is a sharp object. So try if you can take the help of your parents. Okay? Cutter, and you can use knife also, but try if you can take the help of your parents, it will be very safe for you. Okay, now as you all can see, I have cut the shape of the bottle. Now we'll start with the coloring part, and I am using white painting color and brush for painting this bottle part. Okay everyone? I'm painting it with white color slowly. You have to cover each and every part. You have to use very less amount of water, very less. You will use the water in large quantity, so you will not get the finishing in the painting color. this way we are going to paint the pot using the white painting color slowly. I know it will take time, but you have to perform this task very nicely. Make sure that you have to use very less amount of water while painting this pot. Make sure while painting you have to be careful that there should be no patches on this so that it should not look untidy. And I am using the white painting color. If you want, so you can also do the pink color by mixing the red painting color and the white painting color. And you can also prepare this pot by coloring it with a yellow painting color also. That is of your own choice. And but make sure that you have to cover each and every space. No space should be left without paint. We have to cover each and every space by painting it very nicely and smoothly. And you have to use very less amount of water. Okay? If you will paint it nicely, and so there will be no patches on the spot, which will give an enhanced look. Meanwhile, our pot is getting dry, and so as you know that we are giving a kitty look to our this pot, so we will go with the decoration part for which we require to prepare the ears and face look. So our first step is how to make the ears for giving the kitty look to our pot. I am drawing it in a semicircle shape. It's very easy. We will place the sheet in two folds and we'll draw it on the one side. And we'll get the two ears for our kitty pot. Okay, now let's go for the cutting part. Slowly you have to cut it. Manner you have to cut the two ears. Okay everyone? Okay, as we have prepared the outer part of the ears in the same manner, we have to prepare the inner part of the ears just for giving the enhanced look, and we have to prepare it in the same manner. Okay, but make sure the inner part must be smaller as compared to the outer part. So let's see how we have to make it. Just you have to make the two folds and then you can cut it. Slowly so that it should be cut properly. Okay. Okay, so after cutting it, you will get this shape. And as you can see, the size of the inner part of the ear is smaller than the outer part. And now what we have to do, we have to fix the inner part on the outer part of the ear, just for giving it a different and enhanced look to the ears. Okay, so let's paste it now. In the same way, we will paste another one also. Wow, now it's looking nice in this manner, okay? So now, as we have made the ears, in the same manner, we have to draw a small nose also. Cute nose. And for what that, we have to draw a cute little triangle, very small. Let's cut it now. See, in this way. As you can see, our pot is almost dry. Okay, so now we have to draw the face by using the ears we have prepared and the nose also. Let's give the face expressions to our pot. For that, what we have to do, we have to paste the ears. But before pasting, let's check the gap also in this manner. Okay, we'll paste the ears. So we have to paste the ears using the glue and make sure that there should be little gap between the ears. Okay, you don't have to paste the ears too much close. There should be little gap. See now, this manner. Okay, if you will not be able to fix it properly with the glue, you can also use the cello tape at the back. Okay, you can use glue or you can use the cello tape also for fixing the ears. I hope now you all are done with the pasting of the ears. Now let's draw the face expressions of our pot. Firstly, I'm drawing it with the help of pencil, then we'll use the marker. So we have to draw two small circles just below the ears. Okay, in this manner. Then one standing line. After that, at the left side, we have to draw three lines. This manner, 1, 2, 3. Same manner we have to draw at the right side also. The center will be the slipping line and the first and the last will be the slanting lines. And what we have to do after drawing the lines with the pencil, we'll use the marker. I'm using the blue marker and it's your choice that you can also draw it with the help of the black marker. So let's start. See, if you will draw the face expression with the pencil, it will be convenient and easy for you to do it. And if you will use directly the marker, might be you don't get the proper shape. Now one standing line, slowly okay now. I am done by drawing the eyes, and it was very easy drawing just two circles, and I have drawn whiskers like mustaches, and I feel it's looking very cute. But still, if you remembered, we have drawn one cute small triangle for giving a pretty look to our pot. We will paste that small triangle here, and after that our pot will be ready. So let's paste the small triangle. Here, just above the standing line. See now, in this way we have to paste it, and after this our pot will be ready. Okay now, so our pot is ready, and see how cute it looks, and it was very nice by preparing this beautiful pot at my house, and I hope you are familiar with the material that is being used while preparing this pot, and it will enhance your house beauty also where you want to keep your pots. But add one thing more, that if you want this pot to be hung, so you can make just one hole at the front area and one hole at the back area, so you can use it for hanging procedure also. Otherwise it was really good. Okay, and I'm really liking it. I hope you like the procedure, the way I prepared the pot, and for that let's go outside and enhance the beauty of our pot by putting some soil and plant in it.